Do you know how are your weight barrel and living?
Right, let's say 45, 20 open, 20, 10 start, 10 power, 50, 15, 70.
Yeah. So you still start with no weapons. £99. My God, that was a bit a lot of these players. Man, I'm falling to the sky. Yep, this game you have to survive. Let's grab a pistol. See, we got our pistols already. Yep, see here, the opponent was already there.
Yeah, we've got you. Devils anymore.
No, I'm serious. Double boost. Do monkey. Oh God, gosh darn it. Sorry, I was just talking to myself. Call 98. A dueling time.
Including, of course, the families of those who were killed, the eight people, and
and some survivors as well. And of course, the people who were killed came from the country. There was one British man, but there were people from France.
Oh, that disgusting.
And from Spain, who were all killed in the attack. Now, we understand that there will also be members of the emergency services here.
Yep, I'm so freaking cool guy now. That's it, you finish.
Strong. And while washing the cars, it keeps corroding the skin. the right person to be talking about this. So today, the Church of England, the Roman Catholic Church, are asking their congregations to help root it out.
What they appear to be a boss who controls or intimidates them.
They're suggesting sermons about slavery in car washes and lessons in Sunday schools too.
It is our job as Christians to be concerned about their sons in our country. If so many people are saying that church in the country,
certainly as people walk around, Laurie's still frightened or disheveled in any way, shape or form without proper equipment at the track at 2 to 3. Perhaps it's something which might set the alarm bell ringing.
The information is also going to be sent to police teams to investigate modern slavery. Workers here weren't mistreated, but victims have been rescued in other raids and their controllers put behind bars. Jeremy Hall, BBC News.
In the suburbs of our Brisbane Lane,
a little bit later on. Goodbye for now.
Hello. Ada orang Indonesia.
Hello there. Very slow.
Hello.
Ada
orang Indonesia.
Cloud on Tuesday. This time it's probably heading more towards Wales and the southwest, so knocking the temperatures on the head here. Warmer sunshine arriving for northern England, perhaps towards Lincolnshire and East Anglia. Another good day for Scotland, actually. Plenty of sunshine here. Sunshine for Northern Ireland. Many places still dry on Tuesday and probably into Wednesday as well. Still high pressure to the north, lower pressure over the near continent, and there are some storms moving northwards across France. It looks like on Wednesday. And may well run into the English Channel, but that's about it. Otherwise, it should be dry, some warm sunshine around as well, and those temperatures typically getting into the low 20s or so. So not the heat and not the humidity that we had over the past couple of weeks, perhaps. Still, some weather systems on the scene for Thursday. This one, not really as too much. Most of the showers coming on that weather front there. What we have really on Thursday is an increasing risk of catching thundering downpours, perhaps moving more. Fenton's flabby low looks like heading its way down towards Biscay, but we've still got that unstable air threatening to come in. UK, and it brings the chance of some storms, perhaps for Northern Ireland or Western parts of England and Wales, but very, very hit and miss. And again, many places will be dry with some sun as well. So we're probably not going to see the extent of the storms that we've had over the past couple of weeks or so, but thundering downpours over the weekend, many places will be dry. After a cooler, cloudier start to the week, we should see some more spells of warm sun. That's
it. Enjoy the rest. Mm-hmm. The biggest performance the biggest weekend highlights today at 5 o'clock on BBC One Scotland.
You know the story of how women won the vote. Think again. It was much more dangerous than you could possibly imagine. Women prepared to burn the bomb. They are going to tell you their story.
Don't forget to Lucy Wednesday tomorrow at 8:30 on BBC One.
Lots of potatoes.
Why have one dish? Can you get a fork?
In such a short amount of time.
And I just didn't have the energy or the money at the time to be able to think about what I could do with the garden. But now this is the final step to be able to make this house a home again for me and the boys.
The building work took much longer than originally planned, and with so much going on, the garden didn't attend the pit. It's time to tackle the jungle. But it's not just a pleasant garden this family needs. Holly has another very important consideration for the family.
I've got a genetic condition called ALS, which means that my joints are really hard. So I tear ligaments really easily. I can dislocate joints, and I have 9 bones in the garden. The garden is a safety measure for me. I'm not looking to step down from the starting for a massive step, which is really unsafe. It's completely overgrown as well, and to be honest, I just have no idea where to start.
How much is the budget?
Now let me. Aha, there, yes. Now let's go. Surround it. It looks
bit more intimate, and then I got to the seats that we could just perch on as well.
So Charlie has kept Holly's needs right at the core of her design.
Hello.
But the brothers aren't outdone that easily. They say both minds think alike, and they too have included a large deck on the same level as the new extension.
So if you come out of the garden room, you come out of this top terrace, which is fresh. We thought it was a really nice place to...
What the? Who shoot me? Cherry tree that had the blossom, things like that, that just drew them into the garden, gave a little bit of height and interest, and again, really good for wildlife, brings the birds in, and I think just creates that lovely little dappled woodland feeling, but with the deck and the terrace, yipe!
It's really functional, really accessible, and just a great space to enjoy news.
That's it, the pitches are yeah, brilliant, thank you, much to think.
And it's now down to Holly and her boys to decide which design will work best for them. Will they work for the rich brothers' multi-level decking and swathes of naturalistic planting? Bye, or will they go for Charlie's two-tier garden, which is easy to do? We've got to step down to anywhere we are.
I hold it, not follow me.
Yeah, I see. Sounds like we're going
I bet you washed.
Time for the moment of truth. Helen is ready to reveal the winner.
Hello. Hello.
It's been a really difficult decision. Milo loved your garden, Charlie. Absolutely loved it. And Leo preferred your garden.
Oh my God, Ron!
I thought match the house a little bit more. So.
Not them again. Come out!
Great progress, clearing the garden. Got the levels, the graded ground going down there. So these up here, we're going to start on the decking. Slopes can be daunting for people, but it's obviously really nice to have some level ground And the easiest way to do that is just run the levels off the ceiling here.
Middle area. We have a large pond for the first
sunny space here. And that's just kicking up kind of made more cozy by introducing planting beds in here with very large multi-stem trees. So this space can be very usable but very soft and natural.
So it's basically like a drill down of levels. There's a step down, another step, a super step. This is where you get into the lawn area. Some areas on the left, you get into the lawn, going to meadow. There's some nice native species down here. And over in the corner, that's where Charlie will be working on a pond. But in the meantime, we've got plenty of
time.
Is taking care of the lights. Charlie's taking time to make sure its base is perfectly level. Meanwhile, the brothers are preparing some weed suppressing membrane to lay under the deck to try and stop the jungle growing back.
So that means the filling outbuilding is going to be a lot safer.
Also, you don't need to maintain the stains of the paint. So not only are you going to be less work, but also saving that little bit of money there as well. Now, unlike ordinary decking, for composite decking, we're using these little fixings. Now, what these are going to do is going to attach the decking boards down onto the joist. And what's so nice about them, they have to get that really seamless look.
Наши были друзья, четвертый, я приземляюсь к тебе. Идем со мной, идем со мной. Домой идем.
Да?
The pond liner has had time to soak
up and is now ready to move into
the kitchen.
Right, so leave all that this side.
Yeah.
Like that. Okay. That'll do. So because the shape is actually quite simple and open, there's not too many folds in the liners. And you might think that folds don't look very nice, but things like frogs and insects actually quite like their folds because it gives them an...
Hey, Samuel, you can do this for
me. You just turned it on, I guess. Thanks for that.
Things are moving on a pace in the garden.
Кто-нибудь машину найдите.
Не
есть у вас. Я нашел. Где ты? Папа, еще вас это
нужно.
Есть кангару, я там.
Далеко. For a fantastic vintage mower. I mean, that will be a bit of art at the bottom of the garden. And I found some old beehives, and I'm going to revamp them into planters. Because they were beehives, I'm going to plant them up with nectar-rich plants.
The garden. They won't
be beehives, but they'll be a bee jar full of plants that the bees will want to come and feed on. And just to make them a little bit more jazzy.
Только что проехал, подъезд сюда.
Проехал?
Да, проехал. Вот едь вперед.
While Charlie's getting all creative at the front, in the back garden, the Rich brothers are moving the first plant of the new design of the
Я на УАЗике. Это вот
что?
Вот это было? Вот садись. Ты
второй?
Где ты?
We're using amaranthia for understated uses. It's also nice to have low
connected
cactus.
Yeah, it's just... Fluffy, Куда уехал?
Да,
у меня мало жизни.
Thank you.
edges are trimmed and eaten up with rock piles and stones. Now it's ready to plant.
So I'm putting some spiky plants in to put them up there, which is really essential for a lot of insects that live in them, things like damselflies and dragonflies, because when the nymphs in the water, when they come to change into being damselflies, they have to crawl out of the water and then up a stem before they change. So you have to have what are called emergent plants. So we've got some sedges, we've got some cotton grass, and we've got some water nymph. Yeah, it's definitely marshy. So this is a cotton grass. Its name really does describe it. If you ever go walking in marshlands or along the grass, you see it in the spring. It's got these fluffy seed heads that look like cotton grass that have been stuck onto the ends of the stems. I'm in the elephant boys!
Where's that stuff?
Какой номер?
Четвертый.
Команду надо собрать. The protected hedge at the end of Holly's garden doesn't just supply a pretty backdrop, it provides for wildlife in many ways. By planting a hedge at a boundary or structure, we can provide nesting places for birds, a safe corridor for animals, and a year-round food source thanks to its berries, blossoms, nuts, and seeds. In Hampshire, Marilyn Abbott has planted an edible hedge to form a naturalistic perimeter to the more formal... They've chosen native British plants to appeal to native gardeners, and the choice of plants is endless. However, if the hedge is intended to feed wildlife, a year-round In terms of maintaining the hedge, the wildlife needs to be kept in mind again.
Я мог себе подъем, у меня есть факи.
Стой, вот так что. Я тебя вижу, стой.
Меня стреляют.
Да. Сейчас я подъеву. Давай, садись. Я тут. Садись. Я умираю, давай. Давай, быстрее садись.
The Brothers have planned multiple hedges for Holly's garden.
What?
Патроны закончились.
So, you know, it is more expensive, but I feel like it's very worth it. And I'm treating this thing as catch a bit of wind, and easy fall over. But it's a real safe bet, and all Holly needs to do is water it until it establishes.
Are put in the ground and the turf is laid. As the day fades in reddish, the garden is before Holly called in the garden rescue team. The garden was a forgotten wilderness, unsafe and Holly and her boys. Their garden has had a £6,000 makeover. Excessive practical and state of the family's needs. The project created a two-tier deck from recycled composite decking. It's a whopping investment of $2.5 grand. But the fact that it's low maintenance and has longevity on its side means it's a good investment for home in the long run. We'll keep the boys entertained for hours, so it's well worth its £100 price tag.
Thank you. get her hands on things.
How do you get it in?
I love these chairs. It's not often that you find a set of chairs like it.
Say no more, James, your man. Ooh, he sounds clean.
I think these are quite tip-top quality.
They were certainly top of the tip. These are going to be coming out. Seriously.
Well, I'm really pleased I am here on the day that he's turned up, because all six of them are set.
Yeah.
They're in good nick apart from the obvious feet.
I don't know who's made these, but these are really good. These are really, really good.
Joe's really taken with the quality construction of the oak chairs that Howie installed them.
Now, I know you're a man with your own idea, so can I help you?
Too many ideas, that's my problem. We should be able to pull it back to bring them up to today and really give them a beautiful punch.
Is it possible at this stage that you can just bring that in quick to refurbish the whole lot? It's probably been difficult to consider, but without knowing exactly what they are. So, do you want to come back to me when you start?
Now let's work together. Now let's do this. Now, the lesson's on. We had to find one of these teammates, the fourth team. Oh, look, hear that, team. Over there. Get in. Where the heck they're going? Let me check on that crate.
Lovely indeed. Sarah has her first find in the bag and is tipping to help. Good work, lads. But what does Sammy think Sarah is? I don't know. It's
maybe a different reader. It's not going to be just recycled the furniture, but it's something else. It'll be interesting to see what happens to them. I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you.
Before discovering his love of vintage furniture. His fresh modern designs mix practicality, comfort, and luxury.
I never intended to become an upholsterer. I wasn't going to set out to this. But you could say, upholstery found me. With my creative background in.
What the heck was that?
Chairs, which probably date from the 1940s. My job today is just to remove stuff really carefully. Yep, this is going to be a real labour of love for Joe. He's going to reupholster all six chairs whilst maintaining their original handmade features. Good luck, Joe. Let's get straight up. Not me. Oh, that's what he said. Down to removing the packs which secure the chairs. Also, ultimately, the price, but I don't want to outfight my The challenge for Jack is to comprehensively modernize the chairs whilst thinking of the labor process. He hasn't yet agreed a budget with Jack, but she wants to stay with Jack to fill in her pocket. He gets straight to work removing the chair's old disintegration fabric, supporting ribbons and stuffing. All of it needs to be replaced. With that done, Joe starts building the chair back up. They've got new webbing on there. He's using a tool called a webbing scratcher to make sure the teeth base is taut. Doing webbing is very similar to tuning an instrument. You have to get it where it makes a really lovely sound.
Because
basically, the webbing is the foundation. Once Jay's fitted the new webbing, he still has to work out how to cover them.
The chair is really, really cool. It's a beautiful form chair.
Yeah, we know you love them, Jay, but there's loads of work to do and still no word on the budget. Will he be able to deliver 6 sympathetically restored and reupholstered chairs that Sarah will be able to make some profit on? Back in Sydney's London, Ray's hard at work on the wooden backed armchair. In fact, he seems to have ripped it to pieces.
Hey!
To remove all of the chair's dated upholstery and strip the wooden frame before he can begin to modernize. He's got a big buzzer around £800 to do that, but time is money, and this is a seriously time consuming job.
We had to work. It's a big. Quick, close the door. Now time to move.
Probably some of the best.
I was sympathetic restoration, but I think Jay might have had other ideas. So I'm really excited to see what he's done with them and find out what the budget is.
When Sarah saved them, they were really showing their age. But now Jay has, well, done what Jay does. The simple restoration has turned into an explosion of elegant colour and design. Jay upholstered four with a lovely dry fabric, and the two bigger ones have now got a tartan look. All sets have been expertly restored, but with that lovely and grey fabric. Sold them for a cracking £1,050, giving Carl and his mum £240 to invest in a new set of chairs to replace those old ones. We're with a profit already under her belt, Sarah's going back on the prowl to find another hidden gem. She does so with some style and grace. If it's style she's after, perhaps Robert's old sewing machine could add a bit of flair.
Is that getting back in the car or is it
a
skip?
Well, somebody be able to reuse it.
It's a really sweet little one, isn't it? Do you
remember
being used?
I do, I'm regularly playing phones for us.
Really? I get
your
little
camera
at school, isn't it?
No, I didn't dare wear it at school. Looking at the uniform, you look like a shocking dress. It's probably at home somewhere.
Where is it?
Okay,
they actually all open with the same thing. It's very simple, it's just a flat.
Ah, perhaps in the toolbox graveyard you'll find in many recycling centres.
I'm just wondering if there's a little screwdriver or anything you need.
You know how to pick a lock too, Sarah. Don't tell me.
All right.
Hey, I've got to go, yeah.
Harder than it looks, eh?
Right, tightly select. Well, I'm going to see it here now. Oh, good, now it's stuck. Would you mind if I took it away as the mystery machine? If it is in usable condition or viable or I can sell it for you, can I get back in touch with you?
Yeah, thank you very much.
But thank you, I'm actually right here.
Oh, the mystery machine. Sarah's taking a gamble on there being something usable under there. From what you can remember, Robert, do you think Sarah would be able to make anything from it?
I don't want to say a doorstop because that just wouldn't be appropriate. Maybe a lamp stand. Maybe a beautiful lamp stand. That would be nice.
It really is quite exciting what might be under there. I just find a key. I can try it out.
Well, I know a couple of boys with the key and the secret for success. This is Josh and Ollie.
What the?
Who just love to create. The pair thrive on taking disused materials and turning them into unique handmade furnishings with flair and imagination.
I think we're really lucky in that sense. I think what makes us different is that we have got original here, we have got hands in craft design, but it's like a really nice combination, and I think we've got some pretty crazy ideas and think quite out of the box.
I think it does make us stand out from the rest.
Well, you'll have to think outside the box for this sewing machine or whatever's in that box.
Now, I hope that guys again enjoy watching this live stream videos. Please leave comments below. Please subscribe and follow to my channel if you're new to me. And please leave comments below. And please subscribe and follow to my channel if you're new to me. Peace, Dr. Dean. I hope you enjoy it. Peace, Dr. Dean.